This is pretty straightforward as far as items finding, I'm noticing. I've basically have found everything in order, and I have not had to backtrack for anything. But then again, my logic for where to go is usually pretty good. There's a button there. There's a pond, but I'm mostly about this button. I'm gonna push it. Cause I'm all about that.
That does not sound good.
Vlady, go up there and fix it. You're a Russian.
Why is this place so stupid? Nothing works. Idiot American machines. Well done, idiot. Breaking it will help. Stupid. You should take that dumb PC if you can fix it.
I'm gonna have to in the end. Down to level 2. You need to figure out a way to repair this broken gear if you want to raise a giant hook to the sky. In fact, you know nothing about engineering, mechanical repairs or fighting things means this will probably go very smoothly. Before we do that, we need a step ladder and then we escape from the up there. We need a step ladder to reach the actual ladder. Okay. Thanks, our Pushka. Going on up. I'm assuming we have to go for the office area, because that was one of the only areas that was blocked off. Yes. Yeah, we've been partnered for about a month and a half, 2 months now. No, about a month and a half. Because no one's triggered the second month of subscription yet.
It's time Vlad told you where he is from.
Russia.
He's from small box, very dark, and stupid idiot brought him out of the box, and it was sad. Now, we are here.
Bob, you stupid dummy. Why you commissioned that artist to make these maps beyond me? And they're able to run down getting lost on here.
After an unexpected hit, the maligned author was forced to write a sequel, 1902. This time he saved everyone the trouble of reading the book altogether and revealed the killer in the back flap. The novel actually chronicles a detective struggling to return a pair of defective pants. God, I would love that.
Bob, I don't care how good deal you got. No more lobbies, idiot.
Oh, this is where the giant corn guy was. We need this water cooler to just carry this around my pants. You were mistakenly trying to pick up something else, but now you're in possession of an entire water cooler. You're too stubborn to put it down, so you're gonna find a use for it, carrying it everywhere you go. You need to empty out the water. So go good with my English muffin. That's red marker. You mistakenly thought this was a blue marker, but you don't want to put it back down unless it hurt your feelings. And its feelings, rather. Instead, you'll draw a face on something with it, because you know he likes to do that. Red Marker was always a rebel.
My god, Bob, what is this? There's no way in any conceivable universe that we can turn this facility into a resort. Stop with your dummy!
Welcome to Blankland. A very slick-looking proposal to rework the facility into a high-end theme park and casino resort. It has lots of pleasing-looking grass pointing upwards, so you know for sure it's a good idea. Some notable attractions include Vatland, Genex Kingdom, and Kitchen. Technically, he was actually smart, because the theme park idea is better than making a bunch of corn weaponry. He was on the right track, see. I'm a scarecrow, aren't I? So like, hey, these corns, they make jokes. Theme park. Hey, Ted, since you're so worried about security, I did you a favor and beef up the doors to your room. You're absolutely welcome. You can't even get in. Hell, your stuff is stuck in there. You ain't getting that open. You need a damn nuke to bar that thing open. We don't even have any nukes because I'm too poor now.
Bobby Jerk, can't even get into my room because of these stupid discount security measures. Fix it. I'm sick of sleeping in the grotto.
Looks like a bunch of items can be placed here. Like a water cooler. This isn't basically the same thing. I gotta put like the face on in here. It's gonna be Ted. There's a lot of nondescript rocks. Now this is a rock that knows its place in the world unquestioning, unwavering, happy and basking in its complete and utter rockiness. You've named it Shelby. Oh, just noticed you guys. This sturdy box, we already know where this is gonna go. This is absolutely positively the sturdiest box you'll ever find. Except for the one you see immediately after you picked up this one. You know that known as the Boxer's Remorse. So Bob, what do you think of this? Should you drive me too, jerk? Hi, Ted, this is great. Really excited to see you get into the spirit of things. Add one of mine so we can be side by side. Really think it balances the space well. Have me get by. Crawl under my legs if you want to get by. Do it. Just crawl right under there. Someone's drinking a lot of cans. See, we specifically need that other water dispenser. We can't, like, take this one. That one's, like, not good. Not up to our standards of water dispensers. Oh man, your cafeteria has good prices. The hamburger's alright. Fries are a little pricey too, actually. But the steak has the most pound for value. I feel like there's a good lack of profit margin there.
Take so many useless things, idiot.
You think this particular plastic plant was perfect? If not for the garish pot it was attached to. You have a natural hatred for clay pots of every size, shape, and color.
Bob, where's that idiot Fernando hiding? I told him to refill the coffee trolley with the Ranko weeks ago. You find him, put him in the work and do some yourself, you buffoon.
Fernando's dead. Fernando was too Fernandy. Can be opened from the kitchen. It's obviously the gear. We have a potted plant. Can be opened from kitchen? What does that even mean? But then how do I open from a kitchen if I can't get into the kitchen? Unless there's another way to get into the kitchen. Vadi, do you know another way to get in the kitchen? No, you're Russian, you don't know anything. There's gotta be loot in there, right, Vladi? It's gonna be good loot we can steal. It's gonna be some good loot. Just gotta find it. Giving up on the corn's ability to be weaponized at any level, the scientists attempted to see if they could be of any use in the general workplace. They weren't opting to take naps instead. However, the corn did display a fondness for stacking orange boxes. My man. Which he could do so every time they chance they could. The goal of which seeming to be directing the researchers to do what they wanted. She guys like boxes too, huh? I do them in the process of stacking boxes. I'm really into that, just like you guys are. master plan. It appears to be the only thing Fernando, the founder's assistant, put any effort into. Aside from shredding important documents and wearing fancy fedoras and gloves, it's a very poor plan involving jumper cables, a strange lightning rod, and somehow turning into an all-powerful Norse god. Notes read that the stupid corn told me their secret, and Bombatid will be my assistants now. Well, that's what happened to Fernando. Oh, Vladdy. I'm so sorry. You could have taken a much lighter ball for this particular task, but it would require a grasp of logic that you don't really have. Out of coffee. Living quarters. Oh man, they had some hecka parties in here. Let's balance it out. Use the marker to draw the worst face in the world. It appears you took drawing lessons from a leather couch. That'll be used for the puzzle layer. I gotta trim this. That's what I thought. Bob brought these to help maintain the large number of plants to decorate the facility. The small fact that they were all plastic and didn't need any maintenance didn't deter him in the least. Cool. By freeing this plastic plant from its pod prison, you managed to trigger a dramatic series of events that led you to obtain a trim plastic plant. These events include reaching out to grab the trim plastic plant, picking up the trim plastic plant with your right hand, and wondering why you did all this in the first place. He really bought a lot of these paintings. Technically they're prints, but you know my drift. Shh, no tears. Bob mistakenly thought that capuchin was a never-worth delicacy, and ordered thousands of boxes to snack on. When he was told that the snacks were in fact for monkeys, he ate them anyway. I like your style. It's a small navigational chart of the Pacific Ocean, with a very peculiar course plotted from the United States to an island in the middle of the ocean. Operation Subnautic Adventure. The course has more in common with the movement of a small fly than any nautical vessel. It's apparently part of Operation Subaquanim Vadre. But owing to your poor understanding of all languages, you mistakenly think that it's a chain restaurant specializing in Italian cuisine. Oh man, it's a NES Nintendo Atari 6455 Xbox One sucks, console. Let's hit those showers. Alright, got you.
That does not sound good.
Aha! I finally found you! You've fallen into my clutches, just like all the others. I must say, I'm quite disappointed. I thought you were more clever, more interesting. But no matter. Now, your suffering will be so incomprehensible.
Leave me alone.
Your small mind will
stupid
break.
Stupid plant, why is your face like that?
What is that?
Your stupid face is very bad. Dumb plant. Is that on purpose?
Shut up, you mean furry stupid. How dare you? I am the pinnacle of my race. You will pay for this insult. Let me just...
What's up, boy? Ow!
Chief! If biting is cheating, I win by default. Your plans have been foiled by my plan, which are better than yours. You
good for you.
Dummy!
Good for you.
And I am most certainly not retreating.
You gonna knock something over before you go? Keep up the standard?
You know, this place is filled with idiots.
Especially you, comrade. So that happened. This is Ted's place. Written entirely in blue pen, its perfectly sized paragraphs is the most depressing diary known to man. Highlights include many thoughts on optimal stock organization, regrets on his partnership with Bob, and the sadness that his own project and experimental AI program couldn't get funded. a lab report outlining the fervor test on the facility's breakthrough test subject, the famed female Ruby Queen Corn. Much more concerning than the last one, as it uses phrases like can't be controlled, the corn follower, and much too British. Need to be more Russian. Recommend sequestering subject as soon as possible until further notice. Double Teen wins Big Science Award. Oh, it's Bob and Ted. An old newspaper clipping that shows a very young Bob and Ted winning a science award for an artificial intelligence prototype. Judging by their demeanor, their partnership hasn't changed much since then. The article notably praises the display's slick presentation, spearheaded by Bob, and completely ignores the sciencey parts, which Ted did on his own. Useful. This is a candle holder, a carving of Dave, legendary unicorn brought to life by a hungover demigod. The magical creature possessed near infinite foresight and complete lack of spatial awareness. It fell to its death immediately after it was created. That's why there's no unicorns. Did you know that, Vladdy? A cheap knockoff of a well-known decaf coffee brand. Ronka is unique. Kia? It doesn't taste like coffee whatsoever. Instead, the makers went for taste and texture of an old boot. It's only thing that facility's coffee trolley delivers. Aesthetic. So we gotta take this to the coffee trolley. Put in the coffee trolley. And then it will be delivered to the kitchen. And we follow it to the kitchen. Let's go, Vladdy! I don't need this. Give me a step up in life. Sometimes you gotta make a stand. You vaguely remember a ladder you spawned earlier in West Hook 2 that you could access with the help of the stepladder. You know that your observation happened after a few moments ago or several centuries ago, because you have little to no concept of linear time. Maybe it was the smell, maybe it was the way the light caught the plastic, but something about this particular garbage-filled bag caught your eye, and never let go. You'll carry it with you. Always.
Collecting all of this garbage will not make you less stupid, idiot!
I know, Vladdy. Frame Popcorn Ad. Bob was so enamored of this popcorn brand and its mascot that he framed a number of his favorite advertisements and placed them all over the facility. They were removed immediately by staff.
Bob! I don't care how much you love this food with popcorn. Stop framing ads and hanging them here. It's stupid.
It's not stupid. It's good popcorn. Glue. If you ask nicely, Vlad will fix the door. But he'll probably call you stupid along the way. You figure that this glue may come in useful at some point, once you finally manage to unstick your head from your shoulder. Hey, Dad, just to let you know, I spilled some soda on some of your things and put them in here to dry out. Nothing serious, just some old photos and papers in your pouring pile. Sorry.
Bob, I hate you so much.
You know what would be more immersive in this playthrough? I've had some popcorn with me right now and just started munching it. You know, just some good popcorn. Just start making really annoying popcorn munching noises. Can I go get it right now?
fucking idiot. Off to get more garbage?
Want a popcorn. Qualify. It's part of the immersive experience.
Hey, diddy-doo-diddy. Got some popcorn right here. Hey, Vladdy. How you doing? Now things are rough.
Okay, let's go, Vladdy.
I need to go fix this vent with this glue. We also have a thing, a stepladder.
Why does Bloody have to fixing everything? When is it idiot's turn?
Do it, Bloody. Get that Russian engineering to work. You're so proud
Bloody
of.
Bloody not even sure what to fix. Is Bloody supposed to hit stupid American garbage built by idiots.
Technically, that's true. Good for you, though. Good for you. Oh, I'm going the wrong direction. I had to turn around because I'm American. American no think good. So I gotta glue this gear back to the crank. I'm a cranker. It'll be a long walk or run. Brisk jog, more like it. Welcome to everyone coming to the stream, everybody. There's 232 of you right now, going by the Twitch client on my phone. Thanks for coming out tonight. We might actually complete this game tonight, if I'm really go-getter enough. There we go. Cutscene for a ladder, because we couldn't animate that. Oh, look, I'm up here. Vladdy follows you somehow. It's a Russian engineering. I'm not gonna stand here there, the frame rate dies. Oof. Always go right. It's the right way. Oh, look, there's a pool. Shallow end. We got a pool to give our resources. You like the exotic red and white pattern of this interesting item, which is why you picked it up. It never occurs to you that you might be able to use it to float on water, so you just wear it like a bracelet. Hey, look, it's a rock. You're not really sure if this particular rock is a rock at all, or simply a very carefully colored sponge. You have named it Jarvis.
Yes, it can't do that thing it does anymore.
What does it do again?
Goes places.
All right, yes, I remember.
Maybe move these boxes, you know, like, I like stacking boxes too, man, but you gotta be responsible with box stacking. Like, you can't just stack them anywhere. That's the dark side of box stacking. I should know. I once too almost fell to the dark side of box stacking. Dark days.
The men living here look very poor.
Most men didn't make it. Well, many reports written by the lone soldier charged with keeping this facility safe. After reading this, it seems that the web wasn't a problem. Most entry logs have variations on the phrase nothing to report. Also contains a running count of crossword puzzles solved, which numbers tens of the thousands. Throw a wrench in the mix. This wrench is something you could use to get rid of the chemical liquid that fills the pool. Here's a hint, it doesn't involve throwing into the pool itself. Aww. Hey, look, a chair.
This chair.
You carry this as a reminder to stop every once in a while to sit. Clear your mind and pardon the meanings of all things. You will never do this, not once, in the course of your adventure. Instead, everyone else will wonder why you're wearing a chair as a hat. Because I'm the chairman. A flyer for a local pizza restaurant looks like it was frequented often by the facility staff. It includes a special for their signature quintuple cheese pizza, which it offers to customers for free if they can finish it within 2 minutes or less without suffering a massive heart attack. Quintuple cheese.
Especially like the human organs on them.
But anyway, smell remains. What do we get for pulling our resources together? Toolbox key. There's a toolbox near that strange spire this key would fit perfectly into. Oh god, I gotta backtrack. Like, way back. Like, oh my god. I feel my dice in this area, which is weird. No, maybe not, because I can't seem to go back into this. Lottie! Do you know what I'm doing in my life? There's a toolbox back in the other area, but I can't seem to go back to it. Maybe the corn moved the boxes, then I have a shortcut? Yes, I did. Okay, it makes sense. Hi, how you doing? Now I'll fix this for you. Here we go, I'm a human being. Here, English muffin. Vladi, can you fix this? You're Russian. Here's the barn. They close off the previous sections. Tea party in progress. Do not disturb. I haven't been back here for a while.
What's the biscuit for?
They let us come to the barn for a reason, right? It'd be kind of weird if they just unlocked it randomly. Maybe back to this area with Fernando.
What is this stupid thing? Very important bloody things.
He really doesn't look too good, does he?
No, not at all.
Rather sickly in appearance.
Has he eaten anything in the past year?
I don't think so.
Do you think he has the mumps?
Very likely.
It might have something to do with all that lightning that coursed through his body.
And that he was possibly told he would get godlike powers if he was connected to that machine.
Quality work on that, by the way.
Thank you.
Such as they did.
Oh yes, very much. Good bits.
Oh look, some WD-40. WT-40.
You take all the stupid garbage.
Can a WT-40, the best compound to make engine parts squeaky clean and rust-free, but the worst thing to put on a salad is garnish. Luckily, you don't know what the salad is, you'll never make that mistake. That's a reference to some people actually using WD-40 for cooking and making a terrible mistake. Some people have legitimately done that for cooking without realizing implications of it. There we go. You never iron to be fully ready. What would a tractor need? What do you think, Vladdy? Maybe the tea party's over and I can go back to the other area? No, tea party ain't over yet. Could check the big silo. Hey, Vladdy, you ever been in here? Kinda sucks, right? I'm still waiting for there to be an Easter egg right there. Corn are gone. Well, all of them except for one. Wait, no, your actual corn. Never mind. Actual corn. See if anything new in here. I think you just passed by the barn for the sake of passing by it. I don't think they had any items, because you would probably see them shining up. So we'll go back. Vladdy, where do we go? You're Russian, you should know these things. People are good at getting lost. In direction in life. I never noticed there was a little flag up there. Fuel jug. Rusty wheel. It's a quiet moment. You'll take this rusty wheel and roll along the ground, wondering what its purpose could be. Afterwards, you will forget you have it. Hey guys, got you some fuel. There you go.
Yes, of course.
Drive the tractor, Vladdy.
Stupid thing. Makes most sense. Large chance for pain and suffering. Idiot. What's a boy, stupid idiot? Vladdy do everything.
Man, you Russians are good at farming, right?
Hey, how does Vladdy start this stupid thing? Like this? Oh, okay. stupid thing. It's not so bad. Go, stupid thing, go! Ha ha! This is good, this is... Uh-oh.
That's some good old-fashioned American engineering.
Everything under control! Why you see through? Stupid thing! Go that way! Go that way!
Huh. So that's what it does.
Well, that didn't go well.
No, not at all.
A new path has been smashed open for you. Thanks. All these poor boxes. Then the question is, did the corn die or were there people here? So they don't see blood. I'm assuming the teacups died. It was a tea party, and it was like literally tea having a party. There was no corn involved or anybody. It was just teacups. It was like, imagine the teacups from Beauty and the Beast, and just imagine like hundreds of them slaughtered and screaming out all at once, like blood and guts everywhere, but you know, teacups instead. Well, they lived somehow. Because they had a plant. They had a plant, they lived. Good karma. Vladdy! Where are you, Vladdy? Vladdy? We have a biscuit with your name on it. Vladdy. Let's look for a giant crashed tractor. Did you go into the cellar, Vladdy? Vladdy, are you moping inside? Vladdy, scream louder. Call me stupid a few more times. Speak louder, man. Wake up and smell the roses. You just call me a droog?
No purpose, but that was wrong. It does. It is to destroy Vladdy. Everything here was made to make Vladdy suffer. And you are worst of all.
Don't judge me.
You killed my uncle.
I'm right here.
Oh, that's right.
We're not helping you anymore. You're mean.
Because of the whole running a lot of us over business.
You could have asked first.
And nicely.
Jerk.
Boo!
Boo!
Boo! Boo!
Boo!
There is absolutely nothing that will make us change our mind.
Nothing at all.
Would a biscuit help?
Unless you played that song we really like.
Oh, yes.
At our favorite spot.
That could work.
But nothing else.
Idiot plants. You go. Vladdy fix this stupid thing. You get stupid plants out of the way.
Wow. They're after my heart right here. This is some proper box stacking. Like... This is nice. This is really good. They did a really good job right here. Droog means, dog, if I remember correctly, by the way. Boombox. Put tape in there, hold it up. Take me back! Still love you! These boomboxes were strategically placed around the facility to improve morale. Coincidentally, that same week, the entire staff end up in the infirmary for hearing related issues. Hey, look. What are the odds? A very pointed letter, which was very pointedly discarded in this general area. appears to be written by a scientist working in the facility, and addresses the two founders, calling to question their magical skills, budgeting acumen, and general intelligence. It's out of the bomb in orange pen. Only first name is visible. Helen. You know, sometimes the corn remind me of the... Some of their jokes remind me of like a Rick and Morty, like the heads that fly around, like, show me what you got. Let's see what you got.
Yes, no, you stupid thing. You listen to Vladdy now.
Oh my god, I love this song.
Oh my god, me too.
What were we mad about?
I can't remember.
Neither can I.
Make those rad tunes, a new path has opened up to you. Bloody? How did you get around the table without hitting it, man? You are a good driver. Speaking of which, where did the tractor go right now? Like, did you squeeze it through this path? Without causing any damage whatsoever? Is that what you did? Because that's a pretty amazing... I don't know, I did it. Bloody's a very good driver. He's very Russian. They just get things to work. I don't think Vladdy's down here. I'm pretty sure. But just in case Vladdy is down here, I'm gonna check. No, Vladdy definitely came down here. I don't know how he did it, but that bear is capable.
What is problem? Stupid thing did jump. Next time, you drive. So, what dumb thing is next?
Propane tank. We accomplished something.
What? That's it? All this pain and suffering for Vladdy, and you push the stupid thing into the water? Why you never say anything?
Hope he can bear it.
You know, it's a miracle that Vladdy did this. Vladdy had no idea what he was doing. Vladdy not mechanic. Vladdy could barely reach pedals. All for what? We should see where that stupid floating thing end up. Probably in place with all the water, because of course it would, because everything hates Vladdy!
Vladdy is wondering why he decided to help you. If you get in the boat, he'll still follow. Listen, man. Social links, go. Oh, we're back here. Look at that. Makes sense now. And we just use this to grab the What? Vladdy, go scare off that thing. Go get him. Stop. Stop. Vladdy, go get him. Bastard. I swear you'd have to glue this back together, but I guess not. If I go from this side, there's no way you can activate the... I still don't know what the English muffin's for, though.
No.
was very stupid.
And that's why you do it, my friend. I found you had a quorum.
Can I grab Lottie?
No.
Grab the propane tank. Okay, good. Now don't drop it. Nope, nope, wrong way, wrong way. Okay. Gentlemen, behold.
Propane and propane accessories.
Tell you what, Bobby. Don't fix that gear right up.
There we go. I remembered how to fix the security door. He's hoping you never ever ask him. Hey, hey, hey.
What?
Go.
Vladdy already fixed, stupid door. If I spay on pissing you, stupid idiot makes Vladdy do everything. Crawling through. Ah! Oh! Idiot should be crawling through stupid. Ah! Oh! Stupid virus suffering all this. Oh! Ah! Put some boy! Titania Vesalu, Yetamia Lupu! Vladdy had enough! You stupid, dumb, idiot, American garbage! You.
Good job.
Of course that worked! Because this is the stupidest, dumbest place there is. An idiot just stands there looking even more stupid. Now what we do, stupid?
I walk over there and you call me stupid a couple more times. Audi's ideal world has no events of any kind whatsoever. Someone's been kicking apart these boxes. Now we gotta run down all these stairs. It was this way. All right, we did it, Vladdy. We have power. Probably just doomed all of humanity.
We did it. Why did we do this?
I don't know.
Oh no, what now?
Hello.
Good to see you.
You did a very good job.
Yes.
Very good.
Are you gonna murder me now?
Press the button.
Wowee.
Yes, that's very nice.
We're supposed to send you a message.
That's right.
Yes, it's very important.
They send their regards.
Do not free our queen.
No, that doesn't sound right.
Was it do free our queen?
Probably.
One or the other.
Whatever the message was, that button pressing was very impressive.
Oh, yes.
Very.
Oh, well, right, we should probably go.
Yes, that would make sense.
So what do we do now?
Something productive.
Another nap?
Yes.
That's the most productive thing I can think of.
Vladdy do not know what worse. Idiot plants, the stupid ugly idiot plant, or you. No, Vladdy no. It is you. Idiot.
Good for you. Well, it was at approximately 3 seconds. They were right.
Bob, I was a one-way for 9 to 2, but all useful. I'm part of older elevators that you don't understand. The stupid thing is expensive, completely useless death trap torch.
Let's go, Vladdy. Oh man, I got gold ones down here. Nice. Nice. Very tasteful. A blueprint for the room with all the vats near the facility entrance. It reveals that the vats contain hydrogen and oxygen in massive quantities, and they all feed to a central location. Essentially, it's a massive fuel source, but you're not interested in that as much as it notes some possible points of interest for a tour. We're in my bomb. Oh, you have four of them. Wow. Nice. You're right. Walk it off, you're Russian.
Everything in this place is so stupid!
Vladdy's questioning everything about his venture. Oh man, it's like one of those things from Looney Tunes. There's no hallway, but we painted one, so it works.
Bomb, you twit! Where's the hallway? I broke my nose running into a stupidly painted wall.
Sorry, Dad, you told me about that. I sold it for scrap to pay for the lobbies. Whoops. It's like he's playing XCOM. Decommissioning areas, whatever area's in.
Bomb, get off your bulbous behind and feed your stupid fish. Drinking all last week to fill the dozens of stupid tanks in this dumb place.
Yes, why not? Another stupid door for Vladdy to fix.
Why did you start so far away from the council?
So boy, Vladdy know what to do. Just hit stupid thing until...
Oh.
What a stupid place this is.
Vladdy! Good job. Keycard slot. Wow. I can't tell if that's like a conveniently placed crowbar or if it's actually a reference to Gordon Freeman.
Bob, I'm not going to ask you again. Clean your own fish tanks. I lost all the July because of you, jerk.
Americans should be working on more important things like surviving winter or being less stupid.
Doesn't work. A very serious letter informing the heads of the facility that they will be subject of a very thorough audit by the government in the near future. Judging by the amount of nose written across the page, Ted did not take the news too well.
Bob, in the rare occurrence that you're actually doing erecting statues to yourself, would you just like to inform me that we're being audited? And how are we going to explain where all this money went? And why is our talking corner all over this stupid facility? I knew I shouldn't have indulged you, you half-witted, stupid, not-kissed, buffoonish, ridiculous moron. You drove me to erect that stupid statue myself. It was made of rare earth metals. It cost millions.
Hiya, Dad. We're in a pickle, aren't we? Not to worry. I've got a couple more ideas on my sleeve. I'll make all this money back in a jiffy.
For God's sake, Bob, no tours, no resorts, no casinos, idiot.
Another bottle lab key. You get that? You think of that closet often in your quieter moments. I used to go down to the closet during my saddest days. I'd go there and weep for what had become of man. But I would never find a solution. Only that I should keep going strong, despite what have happened. Truly sad days. Really sad. Rock. A rock that is subject to flights of fancy, unable to keep a fond in its head for more than a few moments without moving on to the next one. It is currently thinking of re-enrolling in college. Ooh boy, that's gonna... Just as soon as it determines what a college is. If name of Jeeves. A half-full vial. Looks like someone used this vial and resealed it. This is half-full of someone's blood. It's labeled with a piece of tape which has a name written in orange pen. Helen. The Queen. Maybe they used the scientist Helen to make the female corn. Need something else. Muffin! A effective in making any encounter feel more like home, although you'll never be sure if that is in fact its original color scheme or a pattern of stains better left unknowable. The question remains in your mind for several days. Hi, Dad. I think we're on something with a new batch of test corn. Pretty sure I saw one move the other day. Exciting.
Bob, these are all carrots. You're an idiot, you moron.
Let's go, Vladdy. We'll head back to the bio lab and then we'll loop back around. We need a finger. Damn, Bob knew how to party. They gotta hang with this guy, man. Bob knows how to rock. Hi, Ted. Got some of the lyrics down during my shift. Think it's really gonna be a hit.
Bob, you wrote one line, you lazy slob. Do the same until you smarten up.
Looks like this is the booking schedule for this really recording studio. Most notable is that neither of the founders seem to have occupied the studio at the same time, except for a very brief 2-minute interval once a week or so. According to famous rock band Logic, this should have been made for ideal working conditions. It's true. It's so true. Ted, great news. Did some focus testing for the song, and guess what? It's a hit. The audience really had an ear for it. You get it? It's corn. Oh, wait. I literally said the same thing that he was going to say. I wasn't actually reading what he was saying. Wow, we think alike.
Stop playing around with the corn and get back into the studio. We have no time to waste, Twit.
In blue pen.
I live a life of a lonely man. It's plagued by a brilliant mind. An imbecile for a right hand and a prism I'm inside.
The next lines are in red pen.
I need a girl who understands the burdens of this life. What names will go after an empress and in whom I can confide.
Nice song.
Bobby, musically illiterate halfwit. You can't change the key 16 times in one song. And they pass up because of all the shifts.
Glitter and rhinestones. Can bedazzle even the most dazzling of items. You spent the next hour afterward wondering if that was a paradox, and the next we figure out what a paradox is. Oh my god.
Bob, despite your best efforts, I actually think the song is acceptable. Although I despise your presence of every fiber of my being. Get down here so we can press a copy of the song, moron.
Technically, Ted, if I think of the I'm gonna make him sound like the Beatles from now on.
And you'd better deliver on those distribution plans, dummy.
Hey, Ted, whoops, looks like our costs overrans ate into the description budget. As in, it's gone, sorry. Probably shouldn't have made that power ballad cover. That sure got expensive. Live and learn.
Hanging on the edge of tomorrow.
What? I knew you stole my fingerprint. You glowy hogging buffoon.
We need to get these fingerprints from this thingamafunga. First, we're gonna take this speaker. You mistook this for a peculiar animal and waited several hours for it to say something to you. But then you decided to take it. You now carry it over your head like a battle standard.
Again with garbage? These are all useless things you take, idiot.
Listen, Bob. We got this. You don't think this was an instrument. Instead, you thought there was something for a stone in order to be taller for a little while. You stood on for 6 hours, regretting nothing. Let's go. So why is the biolab a music station? I need a key, FOB.
Well, Bob, I hope you're happy. All the fish are dead. I'm pointing this out in case you're wondering why all the facility smells like a bad sushi restaurant dote.
That looks a stepladder, but don't need it. Hey, Ted, check out the new security measure ad. Install it in a few high security places. Sales of the single are gonna go through the roof. Does absolutely nothing.
Bob, you dummy. Now everyone hates the song because they've heard it 10 times a day.
We need like a vinyl record.
Bob, I saw her talking to the isolated subject again. For change, do something useful and make the security room more secure, Dolt. Well done, you idiot. Now we're all locked out. Fix the lift, moron.
Facial recognition again. Boy. So let's take thing of what items we have. We have instruments. This is for, I think, standing up on something. Banging this against a wall. Glitter that can bedazzle the most bedazzling of items. What was the coffee trolley for? I don't get your purpose in life, coffee trolley. I really don't. The vial already went in the centrifuge. Don't be a Vladdy now. Things I can interact with. Keyboard. I don't have anything to take the fingerprints off. So I need something to take the fingerprints off. Let's take it slow, look for the entire area. What's the English muffin mean? You were small, weren't you? Well known with my bypass fingerprint security scans of facility was to pull a fingerprint onto a piece of tape and put over the scanner. Most popular room to breach was a fabled nap room, which I formerly never encountered on your journey. What does English muffin mean? Even Bob's fingerprint looks like he wants to sell you something cheaply made for a large profit. Use a bypass an extremely secure system the founder set up to make sure they were both present to press a new version of the single, a system which Bob got around easily. You can actually see the example right here, that he used tape. Right, let's jam. There's an industry knowledge of Snowden at the time, each CD of the founder's pop single cost several thousand dollars to press, which made this the most cost-efficient operation at the facility.
Circumstances too large for us to comprehend. Or maybe because it's sunny outside.
Yes, of course.
Well, zeros in this voice is hard to fathom.
I don't know.
Should we go?
Here's another one of these things. Bob, where in God's name is everyone? What happened to all our staff? Hey, Ted. Think I left a no-no about that. Had to let them all go to cover the recording costs. Also, FYI, we have no money left. Whoops. Another one of these eggs. I was very disappointed when they hey, look, it's a fancy hat.
Take so much garbage. There is no more garbage left for anyone else.
This may be a fancy hat, but it isn't the fanciest hat in the land. The towel belongs to a top-notch brown bowler owned by an office clerk in Brighton. Gotta find a coin. Or an English muffin. I'm gonna smash the egg with the English muffin. Damn it. Damn. Damn. Need something else. Use glittering rhinestones and fancy hat to bedazzle a completely ruined giant Fabergé egg. In retrospect, that priceless gigantic Fabergé egg didn't need any more dazzle, but there's nothing you can do about it now. This is permanent. Use for the security scanner. Scarecrow. Sentient and non-sentient. I'm still thinking I'm a scarecrow at somehow. It's solving puzzles. It's a pretty dapper egg, man. Okay. Just making sure. This coffee machine's gotta be used for something. Or maybe nothing at all. What was the purpose of the coffee machine? What's the purpose? Does it make sense? There's a track right here. Lottie. What do you think the coffee stands for, Vladi? Does it make sense, right? It's like this muffin. Yeah. Face doesn't count as a key. Go, coffee trolley, go. Go, coffee trolley, go. Good job. Well, that's stupid. I have to call the coffee trolley to each room. Come on, coffee trolley. You can do it. Come on. Still stupid. I like doing things in reverse. It's better that way.